This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes the difference between absorption costing and variable costing in a manufacturing environment. We'll start by looking at absorption costing on this slide, and then on the next slide we'll take a look at variable costing, and then we'll compare the two. So absorption costing includes all manufacturing costs, fixed and variable, in inventory until the goods are sold. So when we say fixed manufacturing costs, we're talking about, for example, the lease on the factory where we produce our products. And when we're talking about variable manufacturing costs, we're talking about things like direct materials that go into the product that we are making. This method does comply with GAAP. So if you've had financial accounting, you've followed this method, this absorption costing method. Also, all non-manufacturing costs, things like selling costs and administrative costs, marketing costs, for example, to promote our products, are treated as period costs. And what that means is those costs are expensed in the period in which they are incurred. They do not go into inventory, but they appear on the income statement as an expense. So let's look at variable costing next. As the name implies, variable costing, this costing method includes all variable manufacturing costs in inventory until the goods are sold, just like absorption costing in terms of what we do with variable manufacturing costs. However, the difference is that all fixed manufacturing costs are expensed as incurred, meaning they are on the income statement as an expense in the period in which they are incurred. So costs, again, like the rent on the factory building, that's a fixed cost. Those costs are expensed as incurred. They are not attached to the product. They do not go into inventory. They go directly to the income statement as an expense. So with variable costing, variable manufacturing costs are they go into inventory until the goods are sold. Then they become expensed. But fixed manufacturing costs are expensed immediately. This chart summarizes the difference between absorption costing and variable costing. And you'll notice that really the only difference is with fixed manufacturing costs and how those fixed manufacturing costs or fixed manufacturing overhead is handled. So if you look at absorption costing, fixed manufacturing costs are considered to be product costs. And if you look at variable costing, the fixed manufacturing costs are period costs. So you'll see those fixed overhead manufacturing costs here. We call them fixed manufacturing overhead costs, same thing as fixed manufacturing costs. And you'll see here that they are period costs, which means that fixed manufacturing overhead in a variable costing scenario are go directly to the income statement as an expense. That's what you see over here on this side. And with absorption costing, fixed manufacturing overhead costs go into inventory, are considered to be product costs. So that's the primary distinction. All other costs are treated the same, whether we use absorption costing or variable costing. So it all comes down to how fixed manufacturing costs are treated. What are the advantages then of using variable costing? We know that variable costing does not comply with GAAP, but it's great for internal decision-making purposes. So variable costing, it does lead to effective what we call cost, volume, profit analysis. If you go back to my lectures on YouTube related to cost, volume, profit analysis, you'll see how it's helpful to have fixed cost and variable cost broken out so we can figure out things like break-even points or target profit points or the margin of safety. So variable costing enables us to do that. And then secondly, variable costing prevents managers from increasing production solely for the purpose of inflating profit. There can be some real issues if we use absorption costing with increasing production and increasing our inventory levels, which is not always a good thing if we're not selling the product. We increase our inventory levels and those fixed costs essentially are kind of hidden in inventory and don't go to the income statement until the goods are sold. And it's a way to spread out those fixed costs over more units in inventory on the balance sheet rather than putting them in an expense account on the income statement. So it creates issues, potential issues for managers to inflate profit. And that's why some companies prefer to use variable costing.